So?
So?
Where's your ladder?
The ladder, I forgot the ladder.
I don't think you'll be needing it.
I was gonna ask you if you're sure about eloping, but I think I just got my answer.
Are you sure?
You bet I am.
Even with everything that's going on with your mom and the trial.
We'll be back by the morning, and Mom is gonna be thrilled for us. Honey, are you sure you won't feel cheated without a real honeymoon?
Yes, I'm sure. Okay, now that we've established that I'm okay and you're okay, let's go get married.
Absolutely. But first, yes.
Sorry. What, are you guys going somewhere?
Surprised you, didn't I, huh?
Yeah, you did.
That's good. Good first step, I think.
What are you doing, Dean?
Time for all good little interns to wrap it up.
Uh-huh.
Wrap it up.
According to you?
According to me, that's right. Now, let's go. We're going to be late. Let's go. Come on. Here we go.
Late?
We're late. We're late for an important date. I'm a poet, and I didn't even know it.
You want to clue me in here, please?
Absolutely not. There'll be no more fooling around. Time has come.
For what?
Time has come for you and me, for us, to have a real, honest-to-goodness, full-fledged, I will pull your chair out for you, kiss you goodnight on the cheek date. Let's go. Here we are. Here we're going now. Take my arm, here we go. Come on.
Hello, my dear Lorna. How are you?
Carl.
Isn't that beautiful? It's elegant, isn't it?
Well, it isn't exactly my style.
No. I should say it isn't.
Well, then if you knew I didn't like them, why did you buy them for me?
Oh, my darling, I didn't buy these for you. No. I bought these for Amanda. Amanda Corey.
Internship means a lot to
me. Yes, I know, Jenna, but it's Friday night. Come on, please listen. I made reservations. Don't give me a hard time.
You made reservations?
Yes, and we have 15 minutes to use them or lose them. So let's go. Come on, here we go. We're going now. Here we go out the dinner.
Where did you make them?
Tops. I made them at Tops.
Tops?
Yeah.
Are you crazy?
What?
Tops?
I can explain.
Tops?
If you let me get a word in edge.
You want to have our first date at my mother's restaurant.
Well, your mother doesn't scare me.
Tops.
Your father doesn't
tops.
Scare me. Would you stop saying tops? Yes.
Well,
tops.
They're not going to like this one bit.
Oh, I don't really care one bit, to tell you the truth. Jenna, listen. We learned a little bit extra about each other the other night on the balcony, did we not?
Yeah.
Right.
I learned that you have a death wish.
Can I please be serious here?
I don't know. Can you be?
We have feelings for each other, do we not?
Feelings?
Yes. We need to explore that.
Explore?
We need to look at it closely, break it down, sort it out.
Have you been watching Phil or Oprah or something?
I've been watching you. I can't get you out of my head, Jenna.
Dean, I told you I needed time.
Well, I'm willing to give you time.
No, you're not.
Yes, I am.
You're here pitching yourself to me when you know that I haven't even figured out how I feel for Matt, let alone...
I know that you were with Matt yesterday.
You do?
Yes, yes. Look, I don't even want to talk about that. I want to talk about me tonight and you and baked clams and ziti and mozzarella marinara.
Henry doesn't make ziti.
Well, I don't care. I'll eat whatever the guy makes. Just please say you'll go out with me, please. Please. Come on, just say you'll go out with me. Come on, please.
I don't know, okay?
I'll act civilized. I promise. I will. I'll be civilized.
What does that mean?
I don't know. I won't lick my plate unless, of course, it's very tasty. I can't be held responsible. Just say you'll go out with me. Come on, please. You'll go out with me. Say it, please. Please.
Okay.
Okay?
Yes.
Yes?
Yes!
Great! That's great. Here, you can have this now.
Thank you.
All right.
Let me get that.
Get it. Go ahead, baby. I'm starving.
Amanda Corey's office.
Hi, Jenna. It's Matt. Please don't hang up.
I won't.
Good. Good. That's a good start. How are you?
I'm fine. How's your mother today?
The same.
I'm sorry.
Listen, I thought that our talk yesterday was really good, didn't you?
I don't know.
I mean, I have so much to make up to you, and I thought we made an important step yesterday.
Like I said, Matt, I don't know.
Listen, you're about to wrap things up there, right?
Yeah, I was just about to leave.
Okay, well, why don't I come over, pick you up, take you out to dinner now? No pressure or anything, I just want to see you. I want to talk to you.
No, it's not, Matt. I can't see you tonight. I'm sorry, I have plans.
Should we tell her?
Yeah, sure, tell her.
Marley and I are going away, just for the night.
Oh, that's nice. Why does it seem like it's more complicated than that?
We're eloping, Paulina.
You're what?
But please don't tell anyone else, all right?
Oh, no. I understand. I just, wow, I think that's great. Gosh, you guys do the most romantic things. Congratulations.
Thanks.
Thank you. You know, maybe this is good that someone knows.
Why?
Well, I was going to tell Mom, but she was resting. Look, this is the name of the inn that we're staying at. If there's any problem, you need us for whatever,
Wait, I won't call unless I have to, trust me.
Thanks. Can I ask you something?
Sure.
Why now? I mean, what made you guys decide to elope?
Well, we just decided that Christmas was just too far off.
I mean, we waited a long time to be together, and suddenly it just seemed silly to wait any longer.
Yeah, I know the feeling.
We'll be back first thing tomorrow. With any luck, no one will even miss us.
Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
Thank you, Paulina. Thanks.
Then get out of here before somebody else finds out.
Thanks.
Forget it, really.
We'll have a party for everyone once Mom's better and the trial's over.
Jamie.
Okay. We'll see you.
See ya.
Hi.
No, wait. No. Here. No one will notice. You're gonna need a bouquet.
Thank you.
Here you go. And wait. This will make you look like more of a groom. You know, if I was the vengeful type, I'd drag you upstairs and lock you in your bedroom the way you did to me on my wedding day.
You're never going to let me live that one down, are you?
No. Oh, maybe for good. There. Now go, please.
Thank you, Paulina.
Bye-bye. Stop.
So long.
Stop. Just go.
Thanks.
Go. It'll be wonderful. I know.
Thank you.
Have a good time.
Thank you.
Where are they going?
Out
where? Jamie's putting a suitcase in the backseat of the car. Paulina?
Paulina, what's going on out there?
Jake, don't.
Jake, don't what? What's the big deal?
Jake, I promised I wouldn't tell anybody.
Tell anyone what? What?
Look, Jamie and Marley are going out for the night. They're going away for the night, and that's it.
Paulina, what aren't you telling me?
You really want me to tell you?
Yes, I really want you to tell me.
Fine. Jamie and Marley are eloping tonight.
Right this way.
Ah!
I'll do that. Sorry.
Thank you.
Excuse me. I hope you have a lovely evening, Senorina Jenna.
Thank you. See? Just like I thought, no ziti.
Well, order whatever you want. It's okay.
Okay.
Yeah. Now, the last time I was in here, it was supposed to be my treat, you know? Yeah. But I was flat broke.
What'd you do?
Well, I ordered one salad for us to split, and I kept getting refills of bread and water and stuff. But hey, you know, everything's okay now. Just order whatever you want. So, how's it going at school? How's that?
Oh, it's pretty good so far. I mean, it's a lot of work, but my internship at Brava is keeping me very busy.
Yeah?
Yeah.
What courses are you taking over there?
Well, the basic requirements, Western Civ, biology, freshman English.
Mm-hmm.
And phys ed, if you can believe it.
Why? I thought you could pick whatever you want. Isn't that what college is about? I mean, pick the things that you want. What is this requirement?
Didn't you have to,
stuff?
Oh, that's right. I'm sorry you didn't go to college. I forgot.
Well, don't worry about it. Don't be sorry or anything.
Well, I shouldn't be talking about that anyway.
I'm interested to know what you're doing, you know?
Oh, come on, Dean. My freshman bio course does not exactly hold up next to your music career.
Sure it does. Of course it does. Something wrong?
Well, yeah, I keep thinking that Felicia and Lucas are gonna come walking in and send me to my room without any supper.
That is not gonna happen tonight, okay?
How do you know that?
Well, they're not in the building.
What, you checked?
Of course I checked. I might be a little crazy, Jenna, but I'm not stupid, all right?
Did you send them on a wild goose chase?
No, I did not send them on anything. They're in Chicago seeing a play or something.
Oh, that's right. That was tonight. I completely forgot.
Yeah, so you can just relax, okay? The coast is completely clear. Except for Franco, the killer chaperone.
He's, very protective.
Yeah, well. So am I. Protective.
Carl, what on earth possessed you to buy Amanda Corey a whole new wardrobe?
I hardly describe this as a new wardrobe. Now, please don't exaggerate.
Carl, the jury could come back with a verdict that might send you to prison for the next 30 years of your life, and you're out buying gowns for some fantasy woman.
Amanda is no fantasy.
Well, she is for you.
Don't be so sure.
What are you thinking?
Several things. All of which, of course, depend upon the outcome of the trial.
You couldn't possibly be thinking of skipping town, Carl.
Lorna, you really should know by now that I do not take kindly to being asked idiotic questions, especially by someone who should know better.
And I would think that I have earned the right to know what this all means for me.
Yes, perhaps you're right. All right then, my love. If I do decide to go, with or without my freedom, I can tell you this. You will not be joining me. Now, I have a telephone call to make, and I'd like to make it in peace and private. So, thank you. Yes, hello? Yes, yes, of course it's me. Tell me, did the purchase go through? Why? Look, I don't give a damn about the real estate crisis in Brazil. Yes, and? No, absolutely not. No. No, it's not acceptable. The house must have a swimming pool. Yes. My guest loves to swim. And I want to see it. I want to see to it that she feels completely at home.
What are you thinking about over there?
My father, actually.
Well, I told you Lucas and Felicia would
not be coming here tonight.
No,
I met my real father.
Oh, you kidding? Why?
I've been thinking a lot about him lately.
You have?
Yeah. See, the other day, I was eating with Lucas, and all of a sudden, I had this real incredible feeling, almost like a deja vu or something.
Yeah?
Do you think I'm crazy?
Please, Jenna, I'm related to Frankie, right? Believing in deja vu sort of comes with the package. What happened? Tell me what happened.
Okay, so we were eating, right? And all of a sudden, I had a memory of being a little girl in a really fancy restaurant with someone.
A guy?
Yeah, only I couldn't remember his face or voice or anything.
Wow.
But it felt like it was a real happy time, and he was treating me really special. No, I was very, very young.
We're fine, thank you. Don't take it. Now the guy's a busboy. I can't figure him out.
Just ignore him.
Okay. You know, Jenna, I know how much you care about finding about your whole background and everything, but just take it from someone who knows, you know? Fathers aren't all they're cracked up to be sometimes. Maybe you're lucky. Maybe you're lucky. You don't know whether, you know, about the guy, who he was or is.
But what if he's still alive? Dean, what if he wants to know about me just as much as I want to know about him?
I'm just telling you, don't drive yourself crazy about this stuff.
You're right. You're right. It's hopeless.
Well, no, that's not true. Nothing is hopeless.
Since when are you so optimistic?
I don't know. I had a couple of spectacular things happen to me this week, you know? I got an idea.
What is it?
What do you say we get out of this place? I mean, I'm a little tired of this guy babysitting us, you know?
Don't you want to finish your dinner first?
I'd rather stick a needle in my eye. What do you say? I mean, if we get hungry, we'll get a burger or something. I don't know. What do you say?
Well, where do you want to go?
I don't know. It's any place but this place.
Miss Jenna, your meal was satisfactory?
Everything was satisfactory. It was excellent. We're just gonna split, all right? Just take this, keep the change. All right, bud?
Miss Jenna, what shall I tell your parents?
Tell them that we went to look for a little fun. We just couldn't find it here, okay?
This is unbelievable.
Nuh-uh. That was unbelievable.
You think those people really believe the elevator was stuck between floors?
No, but who cares? Besides, if you hadn't been coming on to me like that in the elevator...
I was coming on to you. Wait a second.
Amanda,
what are you talking about?
Corey, you are insatiable. Looks like I got some competition.
Huh? Oh. Hardly. I have been meaning to do this all day.
Why?
They're from Carl.
What?
Guy must have some florist bill.
Why didn't you tell me about this?
What's to tell? Carl talks in riddles. He sends me flowers. Keeps insinuating that one of these days he's going to give me a story.
Amanda, I don't like this. You got to do something about it.
What am I going to do, Sam? Call the police?
Yes, call the police.
And tell them what? That I'm being hounded by a man who sends me flowers? Come on.
I don't want him near you in any way.
Carl isn't going to hurt me.
How do you know that?
Because he treats me differently than anybody else. I don't know. He's not out to get me. Amanda Corey.
Amanda? Hello.
Hello, Carl.
You're working very late again tonight, I see.
What do you want?
Well, I was feeling positively chatty tonight. I wondered if you were free.
No.
I'm ready to give you everything. Everything you need to write the definitive article about my life and work. Shall we meet in an hour?
Look familiar?
It's our room. It's beautiful.
Well, we've got 2 hours to kill before the justice of the peace can marry us.
Right, so, maybe we could test out a bit. I can't believe we're doing this.
Our parents are gonna kill us.
No, just mine. Rachel will be fine with it.
I know this really isn't true, but it's like we haven't had a time like this alone in ages.
I know.
So many things have been getting in the way.
Maybe by getting married tonight, we'll be setting a new trend for things, if you know what I mean.
Are you sure you don't want to walk down the aisle in your wedding gown?
Sure I would. But I'd rather go to sleep tonight as your wife.
I love you. Do you remember that night we got snowed in at that antique shop?
There were so many things going on then. I was right in the middle of my trial, and I just found out that I wasn't pregnant with Jake's baby. You were just there for me, not wanting anything more than to just hold me all night long. I was having mixed emotions, you know.
I know. I know, honey.
But that's the first time I felt like I could really trust in your love. You know, with everything terrible that was going on at the time, I was really able to let you love me, and I was able to love you back. Jamie, we are going to be able to have a baby. I mean, I really, really believe that in my heart.
So beautiful. I never thought this would happen, but we're married.
I like the way it feels. What is it?
I'm not very good at saying what I feel.
Can you try?
I feel things with you that I have never felt before in my life. That's my heart now. I am gonna make you so proud of me.
I am proud of you.
I am never gonna hurt you.
You could never do that.
I love you. I know that because I know you. I said I wasn't very good at talking.
Shh. You have said everything just right.
I don't want to do anything to you.
You could never hurt me. I'm always going to remember this night, how much you love me.
Just tell me where they are.
I didn't think anyone would be here.
Neither did I.
I have some work that I'd like to finish up.
Me too.
Listen, I know you're not very comfortable with having me here, but I had my heart set on drafting some letters to go with the press kits.
No, please stay. You know, you work here too. Feels like you've been putting in a lot of OT lately.
Yeah, well, when I don't want to think about things, I work.
What things don't you want to think about? I'm not trying to bait you, Lorna. Is what you're worrying about business related?
I always worry about business related things, Matt. You know that. The video is almost going to be released, and I think it's a crucial time.
That's not what I was talking about. You said you had fallen into some bad company. I was wondering if that's still...
I didn't come here to talk about that, Matt. In fact, I didn't come here to talk at all.
Listen, I know you've been a nervous wreck ever since we shot this video. It's not you just worrying about marketing Dean's music, it's something else.
What can we please stop this before I say something that I don't want to?
Listen, I just want you to know that, you know, I'm here for you if you get in trouble, 100%. I mean, you've stuck your neck out there for me hundreds of times. I can do that for you, can't I?
No. No, you can't. So, how's Jenna?
Oh, what a beautiful Indian summer night.
It is. What does that mean anyway, Indian summer?
It means that it's warmer than usual around this time of year.
Yeah, but I mean, how did the Indians get involved? I mean, where did they come from?
I don't know.
Why don't you go find out? I'll be over here, okay? I'm only kidding. It was a joke. Oh, I gotta tell you, I was really antsy tonight in the restaurant, you know?
Yeah?
I thought it would be cool for our first date to be in a, you know, a fancy place with all the trimmings and stuff. I don't think I'm a four-star dining type of guy, I think.
Well, if I tell you something, will you promise not to tell anyone?
On my honor, sure.
I'm not either. I mean, I fake it for Felicia's sake, but I'd much rather have a pizza with pepperoni and onions to go any day.
Really?
Yeah, really.
Really?
When I was back at the boarding school.
Chilling with the nuns, tight. Yeah.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We had a lot of very formal, icky meals.
Ah, really? Were they icky?
Yeah, I mean, we had to sit up really straight. Uh-huh. And if we spoke, we had to whisper.
No way.
And we also had to chew our meat 25 times.
So you're saying that someone actually stood over you and watched you chew your food?
Practically, yeah.
What a drag.
That's why...
What a drag.
Now I just prefer things to be very relaxed and casual.
Hmm.
Remember what happened last time we were here?
Oh, yeah. 4th of July. You kidding? What a scene that was.
Felicia and Lucas and Matt all... getting here all at once and thinking that we
yeah,
were...
Yeah, oh yeah. They were thinking whatever they were thinking.
I mean, it's not like we were naked
no,
or anything.
We weren't naked.
It was hot and
very
we wanted
hot.
To go for a swim.
Little
Big
swim.
Deal. It was totally innocent.
Yeah. Well, it wasn't totally innocent.
It wasn't?
I remember praying that nobody would find us because I was so happy that I finally had you to myself for a little while, you know?
I had a really good time that night, too. You want to do it again?
What?
Do you or don't you want
what?
To go swimming with me again?
Oh, are you serious? It's October out here, but...
It's Indian summer,
oh,
October,
yes,
Dean.
Indian summer, right. Well, I...
Are you chicken?
No, I'll do it. What? Come on, we'll go right now. I'm ready. Let's go right now. Absolutely. Oh, except there's one little thing.
What?
This time we do it right.
Meaning?
Meaning... Have you ever gone skinny dipping? It's wild. Now, you were the one that said that you wanted to start doing things a little more casual, right? You're about to meet the ultimate in cash. There's no one here, right? I dare you.
How can you do this? No, let me rephrase it. How can you do this and even be charged up while you're doing it?
This could be big, Sam.
No,
really
it couldn't.
Big.
Because you're not going.
Sam, he knows the jury is going to convict him. So he wants to spill his guts. And he wants to spill them to me. No reporter in her right mind is going to pass this opportunity up. No arguments.
Fine, well, I'm going with you.
He's not going to talk to me if you're there. We're meeting at Tops. What can possibly happen? Would you stop unloading my briefcase? I'm going to be late.
Well, I'll sit at the bar.
No!
Amanda, he tried to kill your mother, okay?
Okay. You're right.
Thank you.
Yes. Yes, he is. Okay, I'll tell him. That was typeset. They need you to go down and proof the blows of the December issue before it goes to press.
Oh, that's right. I'll be back in 5 minutes. Do not leave without me, okay?
Okay. Hurry. Sam.
What?
I had fun.
Yeah, me too.
Joyce. Monday morning, I need you to make a note to production. We may have to hold the Schwarzenegger profile to make room for a Carl Hutchins exclusive.
Amanda, you bumped to Arnold for me? I'm flattered.
I thought we agreed we were going to meet at Tops.
Yes, you did. But I changed my mind. I'd be so noisy there. And everyone would be straining to hear what we'd said. Now, I've got the car downstairs. I thought we'd, well, I thought we could drive off somewhere a little more intimate. What do you say?
You okay?
Fine. Are you okay?
Yeah, terrific.
You're not getting cold feet, are you?
Not a chance.
What do you think of having the wedding night before the wedding?
I think we have broken one or two traditions tonight, don't you?
Mm-hmm.
Have you checked out the time lately?
No.
One more hour and you and I are going to be married.
You have to get out of here right now.
What?
Come on, come on. Out, out.
Why?
I have to get ready. You have to get ready. And it's bad luck to see the bride before the wedding.
Honey, I thought we were going to break traditions.
It's my prerogative as a woman to get a knot in my stomach if I want to. Now go,
well,
go.
Where am I supposed to get ready?
I got you the room next door.
You are so extraordinary. I will see you at the church.
Okay.
Or the whatever.
Okay. Bye.
I can't wait.
Bye.
I love you!
I love you.
Yeah.
Is there something within the contract that you...
No, it's you, Lorna, okay? It's your fault. Okay? I spent half of yesterday explaining to Jenna that I love her, that I want to be with her, and I do, but I can't even be in the room with you without wanting you. What? Say something, will you?
Are you sure you really want me to?
Yes.
Well, I think this proves a point. Point.
Here you go again.
You asked, Matt.
Okay, what's your point? Fine, what's the point?
My point is that you know that I'm right for you.
I'm obsessed with you. When the hell is that right?
You can't accept that because you feel that you have to be with all of the Jennas of the world. Because that's what you've been told all your life.
I love Jenna.
No, correction, you love the idea of Jenna. Bottom line, Matt, you can't let me into your heart because I'm the kind of girl that your mother's always warned you about. And Jenna's the kind of girl that your mother's comfortable with. And you, well, now you are not grown up enough to do anything that would make Mommy mad.
You're crazy.
Oh, really? Am I? Well, I think that you should think about it.
Okay.
Let me tell you something, Matthew. I gave you everything that you ever wanted from this company. And if it weren't for my help, you would have fallen all over your face. But the thing is that I knew what I was doing, and you liked that about me. And for once in your life, it made you feel like you had a life. But you can't love me. No, because you feel as though you have to take care of Jenna. You think about it. You know that I'm right.
What's the point? It's too late.
It's too late for what?
It's too late for me.
And I'm not looking, I swear. Besides, you still got stuff on.
Dean Frame, if you look at me when I'm getting out of this water, I'm never gonna speak to you again.
I'm not, okay, fine, I swear, Jenna. I won't look, okay?
Keep them closed!
God, all right, they're closed. Are you dressed?
No, okay. One sec.
Come on, Jenna.
Okay, okay, you can open them now.
Ah, good, my turn.
Wait, you're such a pain.
Sorry.
Can I turn around now?
Wait. Okay. Wait. Okay. Yes. Why you look so happy?
Because I am happy. I'm very, very, very happy. Woo!
You cold?
No.
I'm a little cold.
I feel great.
Yeah?
Yeah. That was the most wonderful, freeing...
thing.
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
You don't have to stop.
Honey,
I'll be there.
In case I didn't tell you, I love you. I'm really glad we're doing this. Nothing is gonna stop us.
Just tell me where they are, Paul.
Look, I know it's hard for you watching me getting ready to be with Grant and to see Sam and Amanda together all the
time. Shut up!
But you will find someone else. It just can't be Marley.
Where are my keys?
Jake, it's kind of better this way, don't you think? Jamie and Marley eloping could be the best thing that ever happened. Listen to me. Just think about it. You won't have to sit there and watch a big fancy Christmas wedding. This way it's all over and done with, right?
Where are they? Where are they, Paulina?
I can't tell you, Jake.
Jamie probably left a note. That's what the responsible doctor would do, wouldn't he?
Jake, stop it. Shh. Jake.
You want to hide something from your husband? Then you better do a little bit better job of it than that.
Damn you. Don't do this, Jake. I'm not gonna let you ruin this night for Jamie and Marley.
What are you gonna do, Paulina? Shoot me?
First-class team, you and I.